Hey guys, and welcome to Old Rugged Reviews, where we review some of the best open source softwares out there. And if this is your first time here, welcome to Old Rugged Imaginarium, where we talk about game development, animation, 3D, open source, and general IT related topics. Today, we're going to be talking about an open source note-taking software with the special ability of editing PDF. And if you stick to the end, I'll show you how to edit your PDF files using this software. And what software are we talking about? It's called Journal++. As you can see, I would say X, not a J. For some reason, they went to X. So, what is Journal++? Journal++ is a free and open source software that allows you to take notes, draw, sketch, and annotate PDFs. This is a versatile tool that can be used for everything from jotting down quick notes to creating editing instructions. One of the greatest features of Journal++ is its customizable interface. You can tweak it to your taste. It's very easy to use and it's intuitive. It allows you to change the color, the size, and the style of your pen, and as well as customize the background and the different layers of your notes. As you can see here, this note has a traditional note look. See, this one here looks like a graph, and it also has a plain background whereby it just looks like a PDF file with a plain background. Journal++ is available on Windows, Linux, and macOS. And also, I think that Journal++ Mobile is available on mobile devices as well. And last but not least, my favorite part and future of Journal++ is its ability to edit PDF files. That is, it allows you to highlight, underline, strike through text, erase text, and, you know, add your own text, add comment, and insert images into your PDF files. You can do a lot more than just note take and highlight files. This software is very powerful. So I will show you guys how to get it and how to quickly edit a file with it, a PDF file with it, real quick. This is their website here, their official website, journalapp.github.io. Or you can just Google them like I have here. The first link here, this is. So if you want to get the game, you click on here, it takes you here. Let's just click it for you, doubters. Same page. All right, then you scroll down, come to releases, Journal++ latest, you see latest here. And like I said earlier, it supports the major OSs we have there, Windows, any of these three will be fine for you. Linux, any of these, including the Debian options here, will be fine for Linux users and Mac users. Here it is, just the lone one. So for Windows users, any of these three should be fine, but I'll suggest you go for the portable version so you can install it anywhere you want. This is an installer. You can also go for it, it's straightforward. But I'll show you how to have it running using a portable version. And if you're wondering, there's no difference. The portable version allows me to extract it to the exact location where I want it. I'm forced like that sometimes. So let me save it. So you can see the app here already. I already have it. So we'll just save it there as well. Overall, Journal++ is a versatile, powerful, and user-friendly note-taking software that can help you be more productive and organized. Whether you're a student or a professional, Journal++ is definitely worth checking out. This is it here. So what you have to do is, if you have WinRAR, I use 7-Zip, or if you have any other form of extractor, Windows comes with one as well, so you can use the default one. Just double-click it and extract it out. That's it. And once you've extracted it, like I have here, come out here. Go to Bing, scroll down. This is the app here. So I have it pinned to my start menu. Okay, this is what it looks like when you first open it up. I've maximized it. Over here, you can change your background. Let's make it plain. Apply to all pages. Make sure you click that. So it affects this as well, as you can see. If you don't do that, it won't affect this. Now let me show you how to quickly edit a PDF file. So you have a PDF file, you want to erase a name and put another name on it. Come here. Navigate to where the PDF file is. Let's see, mine is... This is a risk form. Let's say I want to remove my name and put another name there. I'll first come here to this layers here. Create a new layer. Choose my eraser. Make sure it's set to whiteout. My default is on standard. Change it to whiteout. Then come here. Start working on it. That's it. Edit my PDF. You can zoom in. increase the size of your eraser. This is it here. See, mouse. So zoom in for better control. Done. Now I can put in the name I want. Text. Let's say I want to add a signature. I just come here, click on this image, click where I want it to go. Yeah. Select the image I want. Let's say I want this one. Let's say I want this one. And there you have it. This is an image. Ideally, this will be your signature. But this is what we want for now. When you're done with all your edit, just come here, file, export as PDF. We'll rename it. Let's ensure. And have it saved on our desktop. See. Then I'll start it up. You can see our edit here. Perfect. Scroll down. See our signature. Awesome. It just works. All right, guys. That's it for this review. Thanks for watching. Thanks for staying to the very end as well. See you guys soon. Bye.